Hi everyone, this is Daryl Sweetland, or Daz, from Thailand Wild. I've decided to put a little introductory clip onto future videos, just to give you a sense of where I'm filming, and also to give a chance perhaps to answer questions or reflect on comments that have come up in other videos. I'm a teacher myself, so if there are any teachers, educators out there that would like to use the clips, but would like some more information or about where we're filming, about the wildlife that we film, please leave a comment or send a message directly to me. You might hear a lot of sound up in the trees around me and perhaps can already guess where I am or what I'm filming today. This one is for Joshua. Joshua lives in Bromsgrove in the United Kingdom. I know you watch the YouTube channel, Joshua, and I know you like the clip with the golden tree snake eating the gecko. So I will try to find another snake for you very soon. This one is not a snake today. It's something very different, and I hope you'll all enjoy it. This is a Lyle's flying fox, and as you've probably gathered by now, there is a whole colony of them up in these trees here at Wat Poh Bang Khla in Chechang Sao province, just east of Bangkok. This species is listed as vulnerable, and it's thought that perhaps 30% of the population has been lost in the last couple of decades. In the daytime, they hang out in these trees, cleaning, as you can see here, this one thoroughly cleaning itself, squabbling, scratching, and even at times, sleeping. These ones using one of their wings as a fan. They're up here in the sun. I found this very curious that while they're out in the sun, they're often fanning themselves, but they also presumably want to do that because otherwise they would just fly to a shady perch and sleep there. Different individuals sleeping and hanging around in a different manner. Also, you will notice the different colored fur on these flying foxes. This one a much lighter brown color on the belly. Some of the others are a much darker red. Large eyes on these flying foxes and a very prominent snout. There are very few known populations of this flying fox. About a dozen sites have been identified in the central plains of Thailand around Bangkok. And there are also some populations in the south of Cambodia and Vietnam. And apparently also one isolated population in Yunnan province in the south of China. These flying foxes look quite large, but they don't weigh very much, less than half a kilo in weight.
This, I think, is a male and a female here. At first, I wondered whether the different fur color indicated the sex of these animals, but I can't find any information about that. The individual on the left here with the lighter fur is clearly a female. And here we see this one clearly a male with the prominent external sexual organs. Resting up in the daytime. This one perhaps getting a little bit hot using one wing, as we saw before as a fan. Fascinating to see that. And this one, actually, this one is making me itch. You can see there on the right side of the snout, a mosquito perched there. And actually, these bats do spend quite a lot of time scratching. And while I was filming, a tick did in fact fall down onto my arm and tried to attach itself to the hairs of my arm. But I very quickly got it off. I have been bitten by a number of ticks whilst filming in the forest, and on one occasion got quite ill after I picked up a virus from one. The claw is just fascinating on the, what would be the leg there. Look at that clinging onto the branch, just something so primal about that in our culture of horror movies and vampire movies. But of course this is nature, there's nothing bad or unpleasant in the natural world. Again, the male that we saw earlier looks as though it might actually be getting a bit of sleep here. And this one having a good old scratch. As I mentioned before, I'm sure they have plenty of external parasites on them. These bats are only found, as far as I know, in protected areas such as parks or the tree areas surrounding temples, as is the case here. In the wild, I'm guessing they have been persecuted out of existence. They are fruit-eating bats and they will raid fruit orchards, and perhaps as a result of that, villagers in the past have found these colonies and either destroyed them or driven the bats away. Although they can travel apparently up to 50 kilometers a night in search of fruiting trees. They don't use echolocation. These kinds of bats don't have echolocation, but they have a good sense of smell, and you can see those large eyes as well. Well, as the afternoon wore on, I was waiting for them to do their nightly fly out to forage for food, so I thought I'd just have a little look around the temple itself. As I said earlier, this is Wat Poh in Thai, Bang Khla, the name of this temple. And at last, the sun started to go down. And what I've been waiting for is to see these bats fly out to forage for food. Unlike the smaller insect-eating bats, they actually fly out when it's almost dark. So I've had to be quite patient here. Looking downstream, I was rewarded by a snake swimming across the river. And then, at last, out they go. Just a few to begin with. I was told that a lot of them fly up north towards a national park known as Khao Yai National Park. And then more and more coming out. But as they are coming out, the light is fading quite quickly, so rather difficult conditions for filming. And to add to the hundreds of fruit bats, I am now surrounded by thousands of mosquitoes on my hands and in my hair while I'm trying to film this. Apparently they will come back around about 5 a.m. after a night's feeding.